Hello everyone. So today I will try to have a session of practice about the previous lesson. I mean the writing process. We'll try today to apply all the stages and the steps, right, and also implement the different strategies we have learned in our previous lesson, trying to show you, of course, how you should use this methodology of the process approach, to save time and effort, and also to write a good and correct academic paragraph. So, following the steps, of this approach, of course, is going to guarantee, for you a sound, and well structured paragraph, starting from the first stage, which is pre-writing, to drafting, till revising, because at the end you will come up with your final product, which is refined, revised, and corrected. So let's start first with the first stage, the pre-writing stage, and we'll try now to apply its first step, which is choosing the topic. So personally, I would like to choose the topic of drug addiction. It is for me a topic which is richer in ideas, right? I can generate as many ideas and thoughts, right, about it. I feel myself also able to develop it logically, right, and also to tackle different points within it, right, in a logical way. So number one, we write here. Practice. Of course, about writing process. So first, the topic is drug addiction. Now, my topic, of course, as you see, is broad, large, clear, and limitless. All right. I can discuss it from different angles. All right. I can discuss within it the causes of drug addiction, or the consequences of drug addiction, or also the effects of drug addiction, aspects of drug addiction, drug addiction and its effect on teenagers, clear, solutions, to eradicate this phenomenon, how to fight this phenomenon, and so on. So all these are the possible angles, or ideas, or main ideas, through which I can develop this topic. But as you know, the size of my paragraph is modest. Paragraph length is or cannot bear or stand all those ideas. That's why I need to limit and narrow down my topic, choosing only one single idea or one main idea within it. This idea is going to be called the controlling idea, with which I can specify, limit, and narrow down the range and the scope of my broad topic. So here we'll follow the final model like this. I will choose the controlling idea of causes. The causes of drug addiction and which led to spread of this phenomenon. So here it is number one, choosing topic. Number two, narrow it down, clear or limit its scope. Number three, we said it is brainstorming. Brainstorming. Now I'm going to generate as many ideas as possible about this main idea of the topic, causes. Alright. I will try now to squeeze my mind, to get and to collect as many ideas, as possible about this topic, whether these ideas are relevant are relevant. Now, okay, at this step, right, it's not important. Doesn't matter if some of the ideas, right, are relevant, right. Example, I can, but here, before I start, with Tomin also, I'm going to facilitate my task by applying and following one of the strategies which we learned before. We said that when you brainstorm, you can use either listing or rewriting or clustering or mind mapping. You are free to choose, okay, the way that suits you, okay, and you find it very helpful to you. All right, for me, I always prefer to use listing. All right, listing because it is easier, all right, and also it helps you save, all right, much time, okay, you just need to write down dashes, okay, with the notes you want to develop. So, learn how now to use, okay, strategy of listing, all right, of listing. So, causes of drug addiction. I think we can here mention, right, the causes as poverty, right. I can also mention lack of awareness, lack of awareness, among people, especially young people, right. Also, I can mention, financial problems. Financial problems, clear. Also, I can mention as a cause here, sentimental, why not? Mental problems, right. Also, I can choose also the notion and the issue of maybe also bad company, but friends. Bad friends, clear. People also sometimes when they immigrate, they become victims of this, okay. Problem immigration, I can include it as a, okay. Then now an idea which comes to my mind. All right, immigration, why not? Right. Also, we have also lack of supervision, all right. Or the absence of supervision, or especially parental clear control or supervision, clear. Also, I can talk about poverty, right. Also, I can talk about, I don't know, the environment and its influence on the individual. Clear. Also, I can talk about mass media effect. Media effect. Also, curiosity sometimes. Right. Curiosity sometimes. Clear. And so on and so forth. Now here I can come up with, okay, as many ideas as possible, but for me these are enough, okay, to just to suit the time, okay, for this lesson, right? So here I have applied, okay, the third step, which is brainstorming through the strategy of listing. Now what comes after brainstorming is the step of editing. Now I'm going to read my ideas to select what is relevant and what serves my topic and to omit and leave out what is irrelevant. Example, poverty, yes. Lack of awareness, yes. Financial problems, okay. Sentimental problems, it's a remote possibility here. Okay, I can add it, okay, to my list. Bad friends, okay. Immigration also is a bit remote, so I will not adopt it in my outline. The absence of parental control also is important. Poverty, I think it's like financial problems. The environment, I think it's like nearly right. It's correct also. Mass media effect, it can be. Curiosity, okay, I won't speak about it here in my program because it will take a lot of time to explain it. So I will, all right, keep it out of my list. So here I think, now I have my ideas in which I sorted out what is relevant, what is irrelevant, okay. Now I will order, okay, here it is, editing, number four, editing. It means selecting the appropriate ideas for my, okay, paragraph, editing. Now it's time to order my ideas. Okay, order them. In editing we select and we order them. Example, I will start first by developing poverty or financial problems as major ideas, number one. Number two, is going to be better friends as my second major idea, right? And also number three is going to be the absence of parental right control or supervision. This is my third major idea. My third major idea. Now here, okay, in this step of editing, I have selected, okay, the relevant ideas and left out what is irrelevant. Clear, what is irrelevant. Now, of course, here, after selecting, I need to order these ideas, okay, to rank them, okay, and place them between the major ideas and the minor ideas. Okay, these are my major ideas, three ones, all right, and the rest can be my details, all right, or my ideas I will use in my explanation, all right, for this. Major ideas, clear, major ideas. Now what comes after the step of editing is, okay, and all the ideas is outlining, Right, now I will write down my outline of, okay, this paragraph, So here, we can write it here. So, first I have my topic sentence, which contains drug addiction and causes. Topic sentence, for example, like this. Topic sentence. It contains the keywords of drug addiction, right. And the contrarian idea of it, which is causes. Clear. Then, I will add my three major ideas, which are poverty, number one, poverty, number two, lack of parental control, number three is bad company, bad friends or company, as you see here, bad friends or company. Right. Now at the end, of course, I'm going to also conclude by mentioning, okay, the same idea. I'm going to restate now, repeat the same content of the topic sentence. So I will try to keep the same word, drug addiction. And I will change only the word cause with, okay, with reasons. Okay, with reasons. Reasons to reflect the same content and same, okay, idea of topic sentence. So this is my topic sentence, this is my concluding sentence, and here is my outline. Alright, here is my outline, which I'm going to respect and, okay, build my paragraph, my draft on. Here I have the topic sentence and its two key elements, right? The topic and the controlling idea. Here I have the three major ideas. Also, I can add under them some minor affluent ideas. Poverty, for example, no money, joblessness, right, and things like that. Lack of parent control. Here we have spoken about, for example, the absence of one of the parents because of divorce, because especially when the child is orphan, things like that. Here also I can add many other also minor ideas, bad company, bad friends, how they affect and influence the child and attract him to be, okay, a victim or a prey, is he prey for them? At the end, okay, here I go through restatement. So these are simply, okay, the many of the different steps of the pre-writing, right, stage, starting from choosing topic, then narrowing it through the controlling idea, then move on to brainstorming through the strategy of listing, then editing my ideas, here my ideas, right? Then finally, at the end of my first stage, I will come up, okay, and create my plan or my outline, okay, or the skeleton of my paragraph, okay, of my paragraph that I should, okay, in my next stage of drafting, give it flesh, right, and make it, okay, or put it in the form of a paragraph, okay, I mean related sentences about one single topic. Now let's move on to the application of our second stage, which is drafting. Just follow, please. Now we move on to our second stage. Okay, we'll try to prepare our draft. Okay, we'll try to draft and prepare our rough draft, right, of our paragraph, depending, of course, on the plan, okay, and the outline we have come up with in the first stage. So we'll try to give flesh, okay, to this outline with its different, right, details and steps, right? And we'll start first with the topic sentence that should include, of course, as you see, the topic and the controlling idea, right? Now, always for the topic sentence, you have to start, okay, directly, right, and simply. So make your topic sentence always as direct and as simple as possible, right? And save your effort and time, okay, and even, okay, ideas for the second part, which is a bit more difficult than the first one. Here, just be as simple as possible and write, okay, average length, usually, topic sentence. Clear? So we write here, example, there are, I must always indent my paragraph, okay, indent it. I write, there are, many causes of drug addiction. Clear? Full stop. So this is my topic sentence, okay, which is, as you see, very simple, direct, and clear. It must be also clear, right? And it contains here the two key elements, which are the topic and cause as my controlling idea. Right, controlling idea. Now I will develop my major ideas with their details. Right, respecting this plan. I must respect my plan. Okay, start with the first major idea in the plan and move on to the next one also as it is mentioned in my plan. Right, now as you know that when you want to discuss and tackle these major ideas, you have to discuss and, okay, develop them equally. Right, it means you devote an amount of details, okay, or explanation for each, okay, major idea. Right, clear? And don't put that all in one sentence, it's very wrong. So first I develop poverty, okay, and we'll extend it with some details, explanation or examples. Then in one or two sentences Then I will move on to second major idea, also develop it or explain it, all right, with details or examples, okay, for also two or lines, okay, or even less or more. And also the same thing with the third major idea. So they must be developed equally, okay, equally, right, and also logically, and logically to have a good structure of my paragraph. Okay, the reader, when he reads it, he feels that, okay, really my paragraph is well organized, well ordered, okay, coherent, okay, and that it depends really on a plan already prepared before, okay, it's writing. So, start can say, there are many causes of drug addiction. First, the financial problems or poverty, the financial problems, okay, are the major reason. All right, major reason. Poor people, all right, consume drugs to forget, clear, to forget about their misery, their misery. For them, it is a kind of escape. All right, of escape. Second, now as you see here, I have developed my first major idea, poverty or financial problems, in one sentence. Then I, okay, extends its development, all right, through another two sentences. Okay, two sentences to develop it more, to detail it more, okay, and to offer more explanation, okay, to my reader about this major idea. So it's not enough always to devote our one sentence for every major idea. We have to devote at least two, three, or four, okay, depends on the time and the paragraph, topic, and the nature. Okay, you must always enrich your discussion of each major idea. One sentence is not enough. Devote, for example, three or four or two at least for each major idea to make it well developed, clear, and well discussed. Second is lack of pen control. Example, yes, also here. The absence of supervision from the parents also makes the problem worse. The problem worse. Adolescents today are the most effective class, okay, in society by this dilemma. Dilemma. if they are orphans. Clear? Orphans or one of their parents is always absent, is absent. Moreover, so as you see here, whenever I want to start a new sentence, right, a new idea, I must start, okay, for it, a new sentence. Now we need to accumulate all your ideas in one long sentence and separate them with commas. It also, I developed, as you see, the second major idea, right, what is it? The absence of supervision from the parents also makes the problem worse. Here is the first sentence which contains the second major idea. Then I add to it two sentences of details, of explanation, okay, to make its discussion richer, clear, richer, and more convincing, and more convincing, right. As you see here also, I have used facts here, facts to tackle this phenomenon objectively. I'm mentioning what is happening really in reality, okay, right, good. Moreover, now we will move on to the third, the bad company, right. The bad friend or bad company, the bad friends, are another factor, clear, that spread drug consumption, that spread, right, drug consumption. They influence, they attract, clear, attract their victim, right, and attract their victim and convince, right, influence, attract them, influence, attract, and convince him to try drugs, okay, to meet, or in order to meet his curiosity. In order to meet his curiosity. In conclusion, or in brief, continue here because the paragraph, as we said, has the form of one block. One block. Now, one drafting, of course, you don't need to pay attention, okay, to everything about grammar, punctuation, things like that. Clear, just try to write acceptable, okay, paragraph, form of paragraph that is identical to your outline. Clear, your outline. It must be in the block form, as you see. It must be indented, right? And the part also should be ordered, okay, according to the plan, according to the structure of the paragraph we have learned together. Now, I'm going to conclude my paragraph. In brief, this dilemma l'erreur de la main resulted or results from all these reasons. Okay. Reasons. This dilemma results, okay, from all these reasons. Full stop. Let's be simple here. Okay. All these reasons. Now, as you see here, this is my paragraph, okay, in which I started it, okay, with the step of stage of drafting. Drafting, this is a draft. My rough draft, my paragraph. Okay, it's not perfect, not complete. Okay, as you see, there are many causes of drug addiction. Okay, here I must maintain the main parts of the paragraph and pay okay attention to them. All right, and don't pay attention to those slight details. All right, first, the financial problem. Problems are the major reason. Here is my first major idea, number one. Okay, I use the sequencers to order my ideas. My transitions here are used also to show the order of my major ideas. All right, then I developed, okay, this major idea by two other minor ideas or minor ideas, yes, sentences. After it, to develop it, to make the discussion richer. Then second also is my second major idea, as you see here, from the parents, also makes problem worse. After it also, I have added, okay, more details, more explanation, okay, to tackle the second major idea and make it clearer, richer, and more objective. Here, as you see here, right, mainly, until here, absent. Then, moreover, okay, this is the third transition which shows or signals, okay, my third major idea, the bad friends are another factor that, okay, spread drug consumption. Here I will add also more detail, more explanation and details and examples to develop also my third major idea, the same way I did with the two previous major ideas. So here, your discussion, development of the major ideas mustn't be dry, it must be rich, clear, rich. Add details, add examples, add an explanation, okay, for each major idea. Then, until I reached, okay, now my complete sentence, okay, which I start it with, transition of concluding, which is, in brief, in short, okay, and so on. This dilemma here, it will use the same keywords. I'm going now to conclude the paragraph by restatement, okay, by restating, repeating the same content and elements of the topic sentence. Either you keep the same keywords or you change them with the synonyms, clear? So, this dilemma from the addiction, here is the topic normally, okay, results from all these reasons instead of causes. Now, as you see, this is my first draft. Now, whenever you are drafting, okay, and a new idea comes to you, you think it's appropriate, it serves your topic, you can add it, clear. Add it, for example, here, right, modify certain things and so on, in terms of ideas, because the process of drafting is continuous until the last, okay, touch of your paragraph. Okay, now, after preparing this draft, right, giving it or giving my plan its flesh, as you see, its form, structure, block form, everything. Now time, okay, has come to apply and practice about the third stage, which is revising, which is now revising. Clear? Revising. So do please follow me, okay, how I should, okay, or I will revise my paragraph. Just a minute. Hello everyone, okay, and welcome to the third stage, okay, of the writing process, which is revising or polishing or editing. Let's call it polishing here. Polishing. We'll try to have, okay, the application of our polishing stage, okay, on this or to this draft. Now first, as we said before, we're going to check first, okay, the content of the paragraph, okay, the organization of ideas, and of course of the parts of the paragraph, topic sentence, developing sentences, and only sentence, to see if they are placed in the right order or not, if they are coherent, if there is that kind of okay flow of ideas, all right, if there is no interruption, okay, or detours in my paragraph, and so on. So all these, okay, represent the first step of polishing, which is revising. Here, first, I will check first the contents, the ideas of the paragraph, major ideas, and the topic sentence, and the last sentence, if they are correct or not, clear, correct or not. When I finish checking, okay, the content and the organization of my paragraph, then I move on to the last step, which is proofreading, in which I will check the mistakes of grammar and mechanics of the language, punctuation, capitalization. I don't know also if there is any kind of disagreement between the subject and the verb, any spelling mistakes, clear, and so on. So let's try to start first with revising the content, okay, the order of ideas and the organization, okay, of my paragraph parts and ideas too. So there are many causes of drug addiction. Is correct here, it contains a complete sentence, it contains subject and verb, clear, it has also the two key elements, cause and idea and the topic. Then first part is alright. Second one, first, the financial problems are the major reason, clear, full stop. Here, okay, I used this transition to order my ideas. Poor people consume drugs to forget about their misery, it's alright, okay. For them, it is a kind of escape. For example, if one of you writes only one sentence for the first major idea, okay, then he directly moves on to the second one. Here, he may revise, okay, this paragraph and add some details to it, instead of joining and linking directly the first idea and second one. There must be here some details, some explanation or examples. Clear. Second, the absence of supervision from the parents also makes the problem worse. Adolescents today are the most affected class in society by this dilemma, mainly if they are orphans, okay, or especially, I can change, especially they are orphans. For example, I can remove the first stop and replace it with a comma, for example, or without comma at all, if they are orphans or one of their parents is absent. It's right here, or is always, I can hit also, for example, and is always absent. For example, here, is always absent. Clear. Moreover, third major idea also, the bad friends are another factor that spread drug consumption. Right, that spread drug consumption. They attract their victim and convince him to try drugs in order to meet his curiosity. Right. Here also I developed third major idea also with the adequate details, explanation, like my two previous major ideas. So it's right in terms of the equality of development between the three major ideas. What is left is last sentence. In brief, it starts really okay with the transition story of this complete sentence. This dilemma results from all these reasons. So let's check the similarity between, okay, or the closeness between the first and the last sentence. Yes, here causes and drug addiction. Here I have reasons and dilemma. It's alright, they are really identical. Okay, and I have recited it perfectly and correctly. Clear and correctly. Now, after checking this order, my parts of the paragraph, how they are related, the flow of ideas, and the order of my thoughts, okay, and the use of my transitions too, it's all right, okay, and appropriate. Now I want to proofread. I will proofread now my paragraph to correct any mistakes of spelling, grammar, punctuation, capitalization, and so on. Right. Now, as if I have checked it now, maybe then I read, I find this one lacks, I find an S, this one lacks, I don't know, extra ED for the past. Now, as you see here, for the tense I used here is the simple present tense, because usually when developing a basic paragraph and discussing a current phenomenon, okay, which is happening at all times, clear, we usually use the simple present tense, which is true at all times, at all times. Clear? For the past simple tense, we use when we narrate, okay, set of events in the past. But whenever we want to talk about any phenomenon, any current problem, right, any dilemma which we encounter daily, use the simple present tense. It's better to make it objective also, to make your paragraph objective, right, and credible too. Objective and credible, at all times, at all times. Good. Now here, what the attractor, what is it? Our fans, one of the parents for absence. Absence, okay, I'm trying not to find any other any mistake of grammar or spelling. About misery for them, sky, okay, both of them was affected to ask society about this dilemma. Right, maybe moreover, the another factor that spreads, you see, factor that spreads, or spread the past if you want, okay, that spreads. I prefer to use to be consistent, okay, with all the verbs and use the same tense, which is present simple tense, clear, simple tense. Also, as you see here, there is no trace of subjectivity, okay, expressions of I like, I hate it, I dislike it, it's awesome, clear, it's good, it's bad, and so on, clear. Avoid all these and try to mention only facts about this phenomenon you are tackling, clear. No expressions of emotions, of feelings, no overuse, okay, of I and we, I and we all the time, okay, too much is not appropriate, okay, to your paragraph objectivity. And as you see here, like this, my product is finally, okay, refined, corrected, okay, and improved, okay, to reach, you can say, approximately, okay, the perfection I seek from it, okay, my level of perfection, which I seek from it. Now, after finishing my polishing, okay, stage, right, and my also steps of revising and proofreading here, okay, I can feel rest that I have really, okay, accomplished my task and my mission successfully, thanks to, okay, that methodology, okay, of the process approach, which enables me, okay, to write correctly and to follow all these steps and stages and strategies, right, which also guarantee, okay, the mastery, okay, and the perfection, you can say, of my piece of writing. Hoping, okay, that you will follow the same steps and stages, okay, and follow the same tips and guides which I offer to you in this lesson. See you, inshallah, in another lesson with another, okay, video. Good luck.